Hi, I'm Sarah Gilday, and welcome to 5 Minutes in Rome. St. Agnes lived in the early 4th century AD, at the time of the Emperor Diocletian, who was especially active against the Christians. Among those killed were the Tribune Zeno and 10,203 Roman soldiers and associates, quite an outstanding number. St. Agnes was 12 or 13 years old at the time, based on an examination of the cranium. She was from a wealthy Roman family, but was discovered as a Christian after she refused to marry the son of the prefect Sempronius. Roman law forbid the execution of virgins, so she was sent to a brothel, but through a miracle was not harmed. So I guess they threw out that little no-killing virgins rule, and they burnt her alive. St. Agnes will become so popular in the Middle Ages that girls in England had their own holiday on January 21st, the anniversary of her death, and there were more churches in Europe dedicated to St. Agnes than to any other saint. A tradition started in the late 1400s to bless two lambs at the basilica built at the Catacombs where she was buried. The wool from the lambs are shorn and made into a sacred pallium. This is a special piece of clothing that is given to newly ordained Eastern metropolitans and Western bishops as a sign of unity. The church you see here goes back to the 7th century. It has been restored several times, but what you see is essentially what you would have seen back then. The church where St. Agnes was martyred is on Piazza Navona. There was a church here already in the 8th century, but that was completely rebuilt for Pope Innocent X Pamphili as a family chapel for the palace, which was, well, everything you've seen so far, and more. In 1657, Francesco Borromini completed the facade. Borromini is known for his swirling convex-concave designs, elliptical domes, and his favorite color, white. This perfectly round dome is the work of the Rainaldi family, with this breathtaking, swirling Glory of Paradise fresco by Ciro Ferri in 1689. For Baroque, the whole building takes part in the pictorial illusion created by the ceiling and becomes a means of a giant display so the spectator will be swept off his feet into the world of the divine. Decorative elements in the church were completed by the students of Bernini, Alessandro Elgardi, and Borromini. One last story. It was well known during the time of Francesco Borromini and Gian Lorenzo Bernini that they didn't really get along that well. This statue, representing the Plate River on the Fountain of the Four Rivers, by Bernini, is posed in such a way with his left hand raised in the air, his body cringing and falling backwards as if he is afraid the facade of the church, created by Borromini, will fall on him. St. Agnes, on the other hand, is posed on Borromini's facade as if to say she can't stand to look at that horrible fountain by Bernini.
Hi, I'm Sarah again, and I hope you've enjoyed this short video highlighting this special area of Rome. I've been giving tours here for over 7 years, and I'm offering these free videos with the idea that if you like the presentation you see here, and you plan on coming to Rome, you might be interested in one of the tours I offer. For example, I do a 2-hour tour of the Sistine Chapel and Vatican Museums. The Vatican Museums are the largest museums in the world by piece. If you were to stop and look at everything for just 30 seconds, you would be there for 6 years. So my tour highlights the absolute best pieces in the museum. Of course, we'll spend a lot of time talking about the Sistine Chapel, but along the way, I'd like to show you some pieces also by Raphael. There's also a fantastic masterpiece in the museums by Caravaggio. We'll also be going through the Gallery of Tapestries, the Gallery of Maps, the Gallery of Statues, stopping to see some very important statues that influenced Michelangelo's painting and sculpting styles through the years. And of course, I'll cover Michelangelo's Sistine Chapel ceiling and the Last Judgment painting that's also in the Sistine Chapel. I'll tell you the history of the chapel. Why was Michelangelo in there painting? He hated painting. He was considered the world's greatest sculptor by the time he was 30 years old. He did say, if you have to paint, fresco was your best medium. He thought oil painting would be better left to women and nuns. So this is why I call Michelangelo the John Wayne of painters. Come with me on a tour of the Sistine Chapel and Vatican Museums, and you'll see all the other great things you need to see and all the great stories that go along with them. Thank you for watching.